Hi, I'm Tom Berkland, author of An Introduction to the Policy Process and professor of public policy at North Carolina State University. I hope you enjoy the book, and I hope you find these videos useful. Chapter 7 is about policies and policy types. The reason this gets its own chapter is because the discussion of different types of policies is central to the analysis of public policy and of the politics surrounding public policy. The two basic lessons, if you will, from this chapter are that there are two ways of categorizing policy types. One was popularized by Theodore Lowy, who created a set of policy types based on distributive, redistributive, and regulatory policy, and argued that there were different policy styles around each kind of policy, where redistributive policy was much more controversial and involved much more conflict than did distributive policy, and that regulatory policy fell somewhere in between. The other way of looking at policy types is through James Q. Wilson's lens, in which he asked, where are the costs and benefits of a policy concentrated? If the costs of a policy are concentrated on one group, but the benefits are diffuse, you can imagine that the group of people that are bearing the costs of that are likely to be much more vocal in their opposition than perhaps the people that benefit from it, who are very diffuse. On the other hand, if the benefits are very focused and the costs are diffused over the broader society, the people that stand to benefit might be very active in promoting that benefit. And that might explain a little bit of why so much of our public policy is intended to benefit particular interests. I also talk about different policy types like substantive policy, symbolic policy, and the like, to help you understand the different kinds of policies that are made. This is a useful exercise to help us understand the difference between a policy that is made that actually has a major impact on people and a policy that is made for symbolic or political reasons. They're important policies, but they just behave differently and the people behave differently in these conditions than they do with other kinds of policies. So I hope you find this an interesting and useful chapter, and I hope you enjoy reading it. Thanks for watching this video. As always, I really enjoy hearing from students and teachers about the book and about public policy. Feel free to reach out to me at tom@tomberkland.com or visit my website, tomberkland.com. Thanks again for watching.